All right, so with a solution in region two, that looks like psi two equals C e to the k two prime x, where k two prime is given by the square root of 2m times u minus e over h bar. We have this expression then for psi 2, where we set the d coefficient equal to 0 so that we don't have exponential increase in this region, which is what we sometimes call our classically forbidden region in which tunneling could take place. So in this region then, the probability squared is proportional to e to the minus 2 k2 prime x, because the expression for the psi goes like e to the k2 prime times x. And so psi squared then is going to go like c star c times e to the minus 2 k2 prime times x. Now, when we combine this together with the other four equations that allow for continuity of psi and its derivatives at x equals 0 and x equals l, the book gives you this expression for the algebraic solution. Now, g here is just a constant that relates to e and u, and it just works for a particle that's incident on a barrier where the energy is less than the step height, and the step function is just a simple rectangular function like this, so that the transmission coefficient then, the result, so it's equal to 16 times e over u times 1 minus e over u, all raised to the e to the minus 2 k2 prime x, which is what our wave function squared is proportional to in that region of exponential decay. And so if we use that result with a value of L, now this, by the way, is a much more complicated algebraic result if we do it in general. It's got hyperbolic signs and all kinds of stuff in it. But in the limit where the exponential argument here is a relatively small number, this is approximately true. And so we have to be careful that we don't get a transmission probability that's greater than 1, because that means we're outside the range where this equation is valid. And so I carefully manipulated the value of L, and I finally found that 5 angstroms will give us a reasonable answer. So the transmission coefficient of E is equal to 1 EV and U is equal to 2 EV then, that's the probability of making it across a barrier that is classically forbidden is equal to, well, this thing, 16 times e over u is 1 half, 1 minus e over u is 1 minus a half again. That's a half times a half is a quarter, times 16 is 4, times e to the minus 2 times k2 prime, which we saw for before, 5.11 times 10 to the 9, times x, which is the length or width of this barrier, which is 5 angstroms, or 5 times 10 to the minus 10. So when we work that out, plug in the numbers, we get 0.024. So that means that there is basically a 2.4% chance of tunneling through the barrier. So that means that it will make it through a lot. But when it does, and you measure it, it's going to have a low amplitude on this side, but it's going to have the same wavelength that it did on the other side. So this is lambda 3, this is lambda 1, they're the same. So that means the velocity of the particle is the same, but only 2.4 times out of 100 will you find it in a measurement on this side. And the rest of the time you'll find it as a reflective electron wave on this side. So what we would say then, in a classical kind of an electronic situation, is that this system has a lot of resistance, okay? Because not that much of the electron probability makes it through the barrier. And And so we'd say, oh, well, yeah, it's got a high resistance, and so there's not much current flow. But this is what's happening, really, on a quantum mechanical level. And the reflection coefficient, since 97.3% makes it is bounced off of that barrier, we get that just by taking the value for the transmission coefficient, 0.024, and subtracting that from 1, and we get 97.6% of the time, the electron on reflection will be found in this region, and only 2.4% of the time will the electron be found in region 3. Okay, so that takes care of the how the electron behaves under the influence of a step potential.